Hi, I'm Professor Roland Kaunas, Associate Professor of Biomedical Engineering and the Director of the Cell Mechanobiology Lab. So our lab is interested in how mechanical forces influence cell function and tissue architecture. So one of our projects that Candace Hasse is doing is studying how to make engineered tissues that are responsive to mechanical forces such as cyclic strain.
Here we have a custom-made stretch device so we can subject samples to cyclic stretch of different frequencies and different waveforms. So here I'm actually doing an experiment with cells encapsulated inside a hydrogel. And so I'm studying the stretch-induced cell and collagen fiber alignment. And so it's actually placed inside an environmental chamber, so we can set it at 37 degrees to do live microscopy during the experiment.
So we're also interested in what happens in the absence of forces, namely gravity. We recently got a grant from the Center for Advancement of Science and Space to send adult stem cells to the International Space Station. The reason being is that cells are able to form complex and large three-dimensional structures in the absence of gravity, things that they can't do here on Earth. And so we're going to send these stem cells along with tumor cells that reside in bone to understand how these two cell populations interact, hopefully to develop a new model for understanding how these interactions work and to develop new drugs to combat bone cancer.
So what you see over here is a rotating wall vessel bioreactor. It was initially designed by NASA to simulate microgravity conditions on Earth. So we use the system to actually recreate microgravity conditions for our experiments. So we seed the cells on microcarriers, and these cells are cultured in the bioreactor. Inside the bioreactor, the microspheres are constantly under free fall, which creates microgravity conditions inside the bioreactor.
And so these studies done using the rotating bioreactors here on Earth are going to give us a chance to mimic microgravity and optimize the culture conditions for growing these adult stem cells with bone tumor cells. And ultimately, we want to send these cells up into space where they'll grow into golf ball-sized three-dimensional structures that more closely mimic cancer growth in humans. Our goal is to use this as a model to develop new drugs to combat bone cancer.